possible, because after tomorrow, you're not going to be able to do any such thing. Of course, we were curious. We ran to the TV and turned it on. At 8:15 p.m., as we stared dumbly at the telecast in front of us, we saw, like a thriller movie, the events unfolding in front of us. Prime Minister Narendra Modi and RBI Governor Urjit Patel made the announcement of the D word, something that no one in this country had heard of, something that no one could dream would be coming to our country. Demonetization. As we stared dumbly at the screen, he explained 500,000 notes will no longer be legal tender. They should no longer be in circulation. Please make sure you obey this law from tomorrow. And then we looked at each other. Then we knew that things were about to change. However, the next 3 days, my mother and I were going to silence camp in Hyderabad. The first rule of silence camp is you're not supposed to use your phone. So for 3 days, we lived in blissful peace and silence in Hyderabad, and we had no idea what was happening too far to say in the real world. After 3 days, when I came back home and we were on the taxi ride home to the airport, I discovered what had happened. On the way from Chennai airport to Adyar, there are 12 ATMs. I've counted them all before, always seen them empty. But that day, in each of those ATMs, there was a line as long as the street itself. People stood there, clutching their debit or credit cards in their hand, staring at the ATM with a kind of dumb fascination, as if it held all the answers of life. After that, I discovered what had happened when my friends explained it to me. At that point of time, I remember very clearly, I had a phone call with Toastmaster Kalyan, where I asked him, how is this going to affect the business world? Kalyan just stayed silent for about 2 seconds, then said to me a little seriously, things are bad right now, but as they said, we can't do anything except pray that in the long run, it all works out for us. We're just hoping. That day, on November 12th, he had given me some hope, and 45 days later, right now, we're all still waiting on that bit of hope that things would be okay. I began to discover the effects properly on November 15th, when I started taking the bus to college. Normally, my bus ride to college has 3 steps. I get in, I sit down, the conductor comes over, he asks anger. I say, Anna Gemini please, and give him 20 rupees. The ticket is 13 rupees. Earlier, he used to give me change without batting an eyelid, and I used to sit in the bus normally. That day, when I handed over 20 rupees after he said anger, he said no. He looked at me, something akin to terror and anger, and he said, no, change kudukano. I rummaged in my bag for the change, and I knew at that moment, I can't anymore think of change as something that I should take for granted. I can't think of cash as something I should take for granted. Because it's no longer taken for granted. We value it more than every drop of oil is valued in the Arabic states. When I went to my college canteen, pretty much the same treatment ensued. I paid 20 rupees for 15 rupee lemon juice, and Anna said, no, change. After that, my mother asked me to run errands for her. I normally allow myself run any errand for her, but that time she asked me to run the most Olympic of all errands. That's right, she asked me to go to the bank and conduct her transactions for her from now on. So I went over to the bank. I have an account with ICICI Bank, but I've never set foot in that bank ever. I do most of my transactions from online. So when I went to the bank, I began to get a real feel of a 2-second transaction. I talked to the cashiers. I learned that they were under stress to provide even the smallest amount of cash. I spoke to Indra, the cashier my mother deals with. Indra every day had the same look of grief on her face when she saw the lines in the ATM outside and knew she could not, for the life of her, pay all of these people what they wanted. Another thing what happened. I was coming back home on a bus and my mother calls me up and asks me to go and withdraw 600 rupees for her from an ATM. Earlier, the process of going to an ATM is put your card in and take out the cash. But now, I went to 3 ATMs. All of them said out of cash. Yet, satisfied. There were people there still at closing time when the sign said out of cash. Still looking. The sort of dumb person. That day, I was in the bus. I began to think over the whole affair. I thought, is this actually something that has worked out for us in the long run? Have we all become so protective of our cash? Are we living in this world and are we going to accept it? I began to think, this is a world where we've been thrust into a decision we never knew was going to happen. And now we're the people caught in this crossfire. Maybe if all the parties had thought through this decision and thought that maybe every affected person's value should have been taken before thinking through a plan. Right now, as Kalyan said, 45 days later, we are all waiting on that bit of hope he promised me in a fit of sadness in the night when neither of us were sure what was going to happen.